Guys, it's Alex again. Today we're going to talk about the 6 symptoms you need to worry about to go get your doctor a visit. I mean, seriously, you need to go visit them if you have these 6 symptoms. Well, unfortunately, this is probably like the 3rd or 4th time again today that I'm trying to do this. It's because my crappy phone. So luckily later today, I'll get a new phone and things will be better. But first off, let's get into it with number 1, frequent urination. This happens because your body has an excess amount of sugar in the blood. This causes your body to flush out as much sugar as it can. And so when this is happening, like, your cells, they normally collect that fluid. But your body's like, I need to get rid of this sugar. So it's going to pull that fluid and it's going to flush out the sugar through your urine. And because of all this, unfortunately, there's some adverse effects. Like dehydration. Dehydration is going to be a huge thing because your cells aren't getting the sugar that they need. They're not getting the nutrients they need. And then those fluids are being pulled out to throw out that sugar. And so dehydration is just going to be a reality. I mean, it has to rush it out because it's like the sugar is going to do more harm than good than being in here. And oftentimes because of this, that your urine is so concentrated with the sugars, you can have a fruity smell and sweet smell coming from your urine. And you know, like, I'll be honest, I don't feel comfortable sniffing my pee, but hey, if you start smelling something sweet and fruity like in your urine, you need to be thinking, hey, something might be up, need to go to the doctor. And then we'll get to number two is an increase of consumption. Now I'm not just talking about food or water, both. Like, that's what I'm talking about. Both of them, okay? You're going to drink more and eat more. And the reason because of this is because that water and the sugar depletion, your neurons are going to fire a response. And this response is going to be sending a protein called NPY, or neuropeptide Y. It's going to send that straight to your brain and be like, hey, something's wrong. I'm not getting food. I'm not getting water. I need it. I need it to survive. I need it so I can function, so that we can live. Like, I need it so I can keep the heart beating. I need it so I can make sure that, you know, the lungs are filling and stuff. I need the oxygen so I can survive. Well, unfortunately, because of that neuropeptide Y, it's going to have an adverse effect on a lot of things. Because it's a vascular constrictive component. Like, it'll start tightening your blood vessels. It's gonna do that, so you know you're hopefully not gonna lose as much fluid and sugar. That's just your body's natural response to handle things. Well, next thing that unfortunately may become a problem because of this is weakness and fatigue. I mean, if you think about it, your body's already trying to use all of its energy just to get oxygen and the sugar. It needs it. It's working overtime. I mean, shoot. If we need something and it's crucial, we're going to put everything and every effort into it. Like, we're going to be all about it. I mean, I don't know anyone out there that hasn't, you know, as a kid grown up and, you know, wanted a bike or something and their parents be like, hey, you got to do something in order to earn money to get it. I think that's normal for most parents. And so what does the kid do? He surprises you. And he goes and he works his hardest. Yeah, he might not have the full amount. Most parents will help chip in, you know what I mean? But shoot, he worked hard to freaking get whatever he was getting at. And that's what your cells are doing. Is they're sitting there being like, we need this. We're working overtime. Give it to me. Give it to me now. But unfortunately, without food, that's not going to happen. But you're never going to be able to supply the amount that they need. And that's why your neuropeptide Y is going to just basically cause you to eat and drink too much. Like, that's just the reality. And the next thing we're going to focus on is number 4, tingling and numbness. I mean, number 4 is tingling and numbness. So if you're thinking about all this earlier, I was talking about the vascular constrictiveness of the neuropeptide Y. Well, whenever you're not getting blood flow to anything, and your neurons are short on stuff, it's gonna say, hey, there's more important things to worry about. And believe me, your touch and your pressure sensation is not one of them. You don't need those to survive, you know? So your body is naturally just gonna be like, hey, no, we're not doing this. We need to survive. So I'm not gonna let you feel things. I'm gonna, and because you're not feeling things and your neurons are like, oh, something's wrong because I can't feel anything. I need to tell the body, like, I need help here. So what is it gonna do? It's gonna send you the response of tingliness. So you're gonna start feeling like your fingers are falling asleep, your toes are falling asleep, arms are falling asleep, and they're not like doing anything. You know, like when you wake up from taking a nap or something, and your arms, because you've been laying on your arm or something, same thing, but you were just sitting there doing nothing and your arms just tingling. Not good, not good at all. The next thing we gotta worry about is blurred vision. Now, just like we've been talking about blood vessels closing, nerves not working right, what does your eye consist of? Water, neurons, and most importantly, blood vessels. So you got three factors in your eye that is crucial, but you're not getting any one of those three to reach the capacity it needs to. This is a problem, a big problem. So because of the constrictiveness of your blood vessels, you're gonna, unfortunately, have swelling in your eyes. And no one wants swelling in their eyes. I don't want swelling in my eyes. I don't know anyone who would want swelling in their eyes. But unfortunately, because of that swelling, it's gonna move the shape of your eye. And because the eye is a very touchy organ in itself, that it's not gonna work right. You're gonna see blurry things, and sometimes, you know, temporary blindness can be a factor of this. I mean, no one wants to be blind, but it can happen. It sure can happen. I hope it never happens to me, but the reality is, if I don't control my sugar intake and keep on top of it, I could go blind for a little while and not get it back. Who knows? The last thing I want to talk about is longer wound healing. And guys, I hate to admit it. I really do. But unfortunately, that's just how life's gonna be. Is because your body's so overwhelmed and so overcome by all the things that are going on, that it much rather keep you alive than worry about a cut on your leg or on your arm or whatever. And it sucks. It really does. Like, to think about, hey, you know, I had this paper cut that normally takes someone, you know, a week to get over. It's gonna take, you know, maybe a month. And that's just your body's natural response. It'd rather keep you alive. It'd much rather be working on the heart and the lungs and the brain to make sure that you're staying living. Because if you know anything about anatomy and physiology, you know that the three major components to life has to be your lungs, heart, and your brain. And if any one of those go out, you're gonna be dead. It's just plain and simple. Like, it's a harsh reality. I know it's raining, but, you know, I need to exercise more. I got the wound back off yesterday, and so I'm just keeping myself going on with my accountability to myself and to you guys. Like, I'm trying to get better content for the videos. I'm just working. I'm trying to do my best, and it's difficult because my phone's not working right, so I'll be getting a new phone today again. And then, yeah, I just need to build up my strength and get back to my normal. And it's going to take a lot. I mean, I haven't been walking that long. And I'm already feeling heavy because I'm talking and walking at the same time. And that's just the reality of my situation is I'm not the same as I used to be. I can't walk like I used to walk. I can't. Dude, I haven't even tried to run or jog. Like, well, I did once. I was at Walmart, of all places. And as I was at Walmart, I tried to get away from Heather for a little bit. And it did not work out. Believe me. I was huffing and puffing. I had to sit there right there on the freaking floor at Walmart to catch my breath. I mean, I was tired and exhausted. And I'm getting tired and exhausted now because I'm talking so much, and I need to stop for a second. But guys, this is why I'm doing these videos, because like, I'm struggling. I'll be honest, like, I wish I could walk like everybody else. I wish I could do the things I was doing before, but the reality is it's not gonna happen. It's gonna happen over time. And I just hope you guys can all understand where I'm coming from, and understand that, hey, you're not alone if you're going through some bad things. Like, it happens to a lot of people. People have it worse than me. And I've said that before. I know you guys know my spiel. But hey, the reality is, I caught my breath, so I'm gonna start going again. But I'm just gonna keep walking here. I'm gonna go ahead and end this. So guys, I love you all. Please subscribe, comment, and like, share to your friends. Nothing better to help me out than you sharing, because I'm just nobody to them. But if you're passionate about it, and tell a friend, hey, check out this video, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you guys, and remember, let's stay positive so we can keep on being happy, and let's do it to it together.